Hey, so today we are going to talk about the structure of the skin. In this video, we are going to talk about the layers of the structure of the skin, the various functions of those layers, the blood supply that are there in those layers. So very first, the skin is spread across an area of 2 meters square. It forms the outermost boundary of your body. So it is the outermost boundary. The outermost boundary, but it's also is dead. The outermost layer is dead because it is supposed to protect you from a lot of stuff. So if you want to summarize the functions of the skin, one would be very importantly protection. It also secretes a lot of substances that is important for you. For example, sweat, which regulates your temperature. Besides that, we can also understand that skin has got a major role in excretion as well, because the sweat also carries some of the ions out of your body. Now let's look at the structure in brief. So if you see, we have three overall structures. So the outermost is known as epidermis, which can be around 30 to 40 cell layers thick. The second is dermis, and the third is called hypodermis. Hypodermis is not technically part of skin, but because it performs the same function, we take it in the same context. Now, epidermis is made up of epithelial cells. If you remember, there are 4 kind of tissues. So epithelial tissue makes up the epidermis, whereas dermis is made up of fibrous connective tissue. And finally, the last of the hypodermis is made up of largely adipocytes, or simply said adipose tissue. So these are the 3 layers that make up the skin. Now, if you see that these depressions that you see, these are the places that you will find the place for hair. So this is where you find place for hair, and the glands that you see branching right here is the one that you call as sebaceous glands, which secrete a lot of oil and other stuff that nourishes the hairs. Now also you need to be aware of the sweat pores. So sweat pores also come in from the same place, and they release the sweat outside of the body. Now an important thing to understand here is the distribution of blood vessels, nerves, and other important parts. So you can see that the blood vessels are only present in the dermis. They are not found in the epidermis. The nutrients diffuse by diffusion, they reach the epidermis. Now also you can find some lymph vessels here. Now nerves as well are found only in the dermis. So this is how the distribution works. Now, epidermis, what are the various type of cells there are that we need to understand? So let's try to understand layer by layer. So first of all, what are the various types of cells in epidermis? So that would be 2 important cells, keratinocytes. As I said in the beginning, the upper skin is dead, right? So why? Because of a lot of accumulation of keratinocytes. And your epidermis also has a lot of melanocytes. Melanocytes have the pigment melanin, and as we know, melanin absorbs a lot of UV, ultraviolet rays, that can help you protect your body. So that is the key function of these 2 types of cells. There are other cells as well. For example, you can talk about dendritic cells, and as the name suggests, these cells, they are largely involved with the immune system of the body. And then there are tactile cells. These tactile cells are basically linked to the nerves, and hence are the sensory units. So these are sensory in nature because they are linked with the nerve endings that you find in the dermis. So those are the four principal types of cells in the epidermis. Now let us again go back and delve into the dermis, because that is also a very important part. Before I do that, one important information is that between these epidermis and dermis, there's a very thin layer of stem cells. Now, you will say, why the stem cells? Because we use enough number of cells of skin almost daily. Why? Because the outermost layer is dead and it gets roughed off. So these stem cells keep on producing new cells, which gets added, right? Now, moving on to the dermis region. So if we were to talk about the dermis part, so dermis again has two types of layers. The upper few layers of the dermis, the upper few layers of the dermis is known as the papillary layer, whereas the lowermost layer is largely known as the reticular layer. So we have papillary and reticular layer. Now, papillary layer has a lot of touch receptors, the tactile receptors are present here, also known as Meissner's corpuscles. They are found in this regions. Now, there are skin ridges. Why? Because you can see that there are these dermal papillae. So these upgrowths, they are dermal papillae, and these dermal papillae sometimes can get atop of each other, and when they get atop of each other, you call them friction ridges. Now, the pattern of these friction ridges, it's very much genetically determined, and that is why this is what gives rise to your fingerprint, which makes your fingerprint very different from the other person. Now, coming to the reticular layer almost holds 80% of the dermis. It's very important. Now, here, just beneath this reticular layer, you have this band of blood vessels that's called cutaneous plexus. Every nutrients and oxygen and other stuff goes via here to the upper layers. Now, this layer is lined, has a lot of collagen fibers in them. So this adds to the toughness, the collagen fibers. So that also creates another sort of lines called cleavage lines. Now, these are lines that you observe as circular lines over your skin sometimes. Now, there can also be folds that occur near joints. Those are called as flexure lines, which are merely the folds of dermis that you can find in your palm. So this generally occurs in the palm. So the palm crease that you see, that's a fold of dermis caused because of the arrangement of these collagen fibers. So if I were to summarize all that we did, so we covered a lot about the structure of skin, the three layers, epidermis, dermis, and the hypodermis. Epidermis largely has cells called keratinocytes, melanocytes, dendritic, and tactile cells. Dermis has papillary layer and reticular layer. Papillary layer is known for the pressure sensitivity, and reticular layer has a lot of blood vessels and nerves going through. And there are various folds that is evident on our skin. That is because of the various arrangement of the collagen fibers and other types of fibers.
We hope this video was helpful. To see more biology topics covered, click on our channel and don't forget to subscribe.